The New Yorkers are calling this one of the worst winters they've seen in a long time. But New York Daily Times reminds us that we haven't yet seen the low of minus 13 that we had back in 1917. Sergei stayed nearly a month here at the hospital, and as you can see, the staff became friends and very fond of him. Hofstra poll was taken before last Thursday's cancellation of service due to the windstorm, and today some customers say that the negative feedback could have been even higher. LIRR did do a cleanup a few weeks ago, but residents are concerned that there's still trash around the tracks and that it may continue to grow. Now it's cars just like this one which are being fixed up by the recycled car program and given to veterans. The numbers are already rolling in for this midterm election, and Republican Party officials say they're pleased with the results. And now the students here at school are looking for ways to help Carl, including creating greeting cards just like this one.
As local news gets. News 12, Long Island.
Good evening and welcome to News 12, Long Island. I'm Sharon Weston.
And I'm Drew Scott. In the days following Osama bin Laden's death.
Now one lawmaker is calling for increased security. News 12 Sean Bergen is in the newsroom to tell us more about that. It's been 1 week since Navy SEALs took down bin Laden in a daring raid on his compound. There's still a lot of unanswered questions, however, but one thing we know for sure, our fight against terrorism is not over.
Officials at the airports aren't taking any chances after the terror scare. As News 12 reported, security is being stepped up at all three local airports. The Department of Homeland Security said a special watch is being given to luggage and packages from the Middle East. So if you plan on flying out, give yourself some extra time.
Do you remember what you were doing 2 years ago today? Captain Chesley Soley Sullenberger certainly does. Today is the second anniversary of the miracle on the Hudson. Soley piloted American Airlines Flight 1549 with two failed engines after a bird strike.
Happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there, and what better way to spend the day than with family? News 12's Michael Baldwin tells us about some Long Islanders who did just that.
Everybody's going to suffer in Nassau County. Every commuter.
More than 100,000 daily riders depend on these buses. As we've reported, the MTA wants to cut $40 million a year in funding for buses. That could kill the bus system without help from the state or Nassau County. That's why Ryan Lynch of the Tri-State Transportation Campaign put this mock funeral together.
No one seems to care about Long Island Bus. Well, we're all here to say that we do.
For bus commuter Enid Allison, who can't drive due to an injury, these buses help her shop and get to doctors.
Me, myself, personal, who I have to use the bus to get to my doctor's appointment.
And a student trustee says nearly 50% of her fellow Nassau Community College students rely on MTA Long Island Bus to get to class.
Many of those students are coming from Queens, Elmont. It would be impossible for them to get to class. They don't have cars.
And another problem. When you slash the bus budget, Lisa Tyson of the Progressive Coalition says it jams up our roads.
If you don't take the bus, you're on the roads and you have a car, if this bus system shuts down.
A spokesman for the MTA says it's working on possibly privatizing LI Bus. Nassau County Executive Ed Mangano has said privatizing could be an answer to the bus budget crisis, but the union representing bus drivers and workers says no.
Least fortunate is going to suffer with this privatizing.
In Mineola, Sharon Weston, News 12 Long Island.
Sergei Masayev and his father met a round of applause at Mineola's Winthrop University Hospital. The hospital staff put on a pre-Thanksgiving lunch for Sergei to celebrate his recovery from his fourth major heart surgery. Sergei was born with a heart defect, which obstructs blood flow to his heart. He speaks through an interpreter.
He says he feels great.
Dr. Scott Schubach performed the surgery and says it was risky.
This was the fourth time that Sergei needed surgery, and we had to replace two heart valves.
He really wants to thank the doctors here, the medical staff, for saving his son's life.
The interpreter, Michael Yurlev, is also a spokesman for the Russian Gift of Life, an organization which made this costly surgery possible for Sergei.
We help children, underprivileged children with heart defects, treatable heart defects, receive open heart surgery for free.
Sergei spent nearly a month here at the hospital, and the staff became very fond of him.
So nice to see someone that just looks like a normal teenager, just an amazing, full of life kid.
In Mineola, Sharon Weston, News 12, Long Island.
Great to see you. How are you doing?
Craig Johnson was the first Democrat elected in this heavily Republican district in 80 years. The former Nassau legislator says he's running on his record.
And I'm confident that this campaign election, you know, we're going to be, at the end of the day, advocating for property tax relief and job creation.
Good morning. How are you?
Mineola Mayor Jack Martins is running against Johnson. His TV ads sharply attacking Johnson are heating up the battleground.
He was the deciding vote to repeal the STAR property tax rebate program.
Now, the very balance of power in the New York State Senate could be decided by this election. That's why Jack Martin says this race is so important. Craig Johnson's election 2 years ago helped swing control of the Senate to the Democrats, which Martin says has been bad for Long Island.
It comes down to someone who's going to protect suburban quality of life and those issues that are important to us out here.
Martin's blasted Johnson's vote for the unpopular MTA payroll tax. Johnson defended that vote.
If we didn't do the MTA payroll tax, you would have had massive fare increases last year immediately. Fare increases that would be unsupported by a large portion of our population.
The race may hinge on undecided voters, like Katie Hansen of Floral Park.
I think it's gotten to be a really huge mess up there, and I think we need somebody who's just going to get in there and take control.
In Garden City, Sharon Weston, News 12 Long Island.
Another animal house of horrors discovered in Rockville Center. Good evening and welcome to News 12 Long Island. I'm Sharon Weston.
And I'm Drew Scott. This is the second so-called animal house of horrors discovered in the community this week.
News 12's Lily Stolzberg brings us an update on the story you first saw on 12, but we do want to warn you, some of the images may be disturbing. Hi, I'm Sharon Weston with your hyperlocal forecast. Today we had a high of 35 and a low of 6, which is below our normal of 39 and 22. Tonight we'll be dipping below freezing, so you want to watch yourself in the morning because we'll have a lot of ice and slippery roads. In New Jersey, a PATH train crashed while pulling into the station, injuring 34 people and shutting down service. The train from New York slammed into bumpers at the Hoboken station around 8:30 this morning. Officials are investigating, but right now it appears to have been caused by a mechanical failure. Charlie Sheen's meltdown at the Plaza could cost him more than just a cleanup bill. The new lawsuit he's reportedly facing from his porn star escort. Plus, little ghosts and goblins will have to keep their terrifying tricks inside this Halloween weekend. The next curfew in one community. That's next on News 12 Long Island, as local news gets.